Opus Clip AI is a new AI video creation tool. Basically, you give it a long video and it will give you 10 short video clips. And it does this all in one click using the power behind ChatGPT to analyze the videos and actually find the best parts of it automatically. Opus Clip will automatically enhance your video, so it will reframe the video to actually look good in vertical formats. And a really cool part is it gives you what's called a virality score, so you could actually use it to decide if you should post a video or not. And it will create really engaging captions with animations. So let me show you exactly how to use this tool step by step. And this doesn't just have to be for really long videos, by the way. I always thought it's for 1 hour, 2 hour podcasts that are in video format, but it's actually working really well for my 10, 15 minute videos too. Okay, you could sign up here at opus.pro, and I'll also include a link in the description if you want to click that, and you just want to sign up here for free. They do have a free option for you to get started. I'll explain the pricing in a bit. Once you sign up, this is basically the page you're going to see. So it's really simple. All you have to do is give it a link. It could be a YouTube link. It also works with other videos like Zoom links, Google Drive links, or you could upload your different video files here. So it takes MP4, that's the most common video type, or MOV files. You could drag them over here or just click here and find them on your computer. And then it's gonna tell you, basically it's great for video podcasts, educational videos, product videos, and so on, but it won't work very well for vlogging type videos or gaming or music videos. So make sure you're using it for the right type of video here. And for this one, I'm gonna paste a YouTube video that I've made. It's about 16 minutes long and it's in educational format. So this is for video and filmmakers that I made this video for. And all I have to do down here is I need to decide if I only want to use a portion of that video because it's about 16 minutes, but this is credit based. I'll explain the pricing with the credits, but if you reduce it, it's going to use less of the video and less credits. But if you use the entire video, it's going to use up all those credits that it takes for a 16 minute video. And then it's going to ask you how long do you want the clips, because it basically turns a long video into short ones, like 10 different short videos. But you could actually decide if you want really short, like sub 30 seconds, or if you want longer ones that are over 90 seconds, closer to 3 minutes sometimes. Or in most cases, I leave it on auto. And if you want very specific keywords to be used in the search, you could also filter based on keywords, and it will take multiple keywords and you could separate it. I recommend when you first try this out, actually, don't set up anything here. Let all the automatic options take place. So I'm gonna go ahead and click here, and then I'll explain the credits. And then it's gonna take you to this page. It says fetching the video. So this is the title from YouTube. Again, you could upload it too. You don't have to always upload it to YouTube first. You could just drag and drop here. It's analyzing. And then I'll show you exactly what happens here. And then I'm gonna go to the pricing page to explain exactly how this works. So this is based on minutes of upload. So right now, I uploaded 16 minutes, but if I upgrade to this paid plan here, I could upload 200 minutes here, which gives me 80 different clips based on this setting. But if I want to bump this up, I could always bump this up based on these credits and these minutes I get, or I could get the yearly option here. So the yearly option is a great deal. It comes with almost 1,000 different HD clips that you could get. Now, that doesn't mean you're going to get 1,000 HD clips that are usable, right? Some of them are not going to be great. It's gonna do its best to find you very appropriate clips, but I'll show you. Basically, I usually use about half of what it outputs for me. So back to this page, it says about 10 minutes left. So it's a 16 minute video. So that's about right, that's about my experience. It's almost real time here. So 16 minutes may take up to 16 minutes. So this is the page you'll see when the video is done processing. Basically, you'll see a clip here in vertical format, and it's gonna show you the script, basically the part of the video that it chose. And as you go through, you could see this is number 2, this is number 3. So let me see how many different clips it actually made for me. So in this case, it made me 13 different clips here. And if I go to the top, you'll see the score. So this is that virality score. Basically, this is what Opus Clip thinks is the likelihood for this video to go viral on YouTube Shorts, TikTok, or Instagram Reel. Now, this is based on them analyzing lots of different videos and based on your content, based on which one is gonna perform better on the 13 different videos it created. And it's gonna show you the length of the video over here. Next, I usually go in order here and I press play to see which one I really like. I'll just give you an example. I'll press play on this one. This has and 85, but I think it's actually a really good clip. And then you'll kind of see the different animation here, the captions that it created as well.
For about the last 7 years or so, I've juggled at least 3 different businesses at any given time. And I always thought that if I diversified my income like that, I would really limit my downside and having multiple.
Okay, so you get the idea here. And these graphics, these are just from the original video. It's not gonna make these type of graphics for you. Although they are in the process of adding what's called B-roll. Basically, it's gonna go and find different clips to overlay. But right now it's doing these captions. It's gonna add some emojis here to the captions too. So watch all the different clips here. If you like any of them, you could just press download in HD format, but you could also edit the clip, which is really, really useful. And over here, you could see exactly what part it chose for me. So all this here that is brighter is part of this video. If I decide to take anything that I said after this, I could go, let's say, to this word backstory. I could click over here and set that as the ending. And you could see it's added that section here. Now there's a timeline down here too. So you can kind of scrub through your video and you can see here on the left side is jumping to that section of the video. So as I click, it's jumping towards it. If I go later in the video though, unless I set this as the ending, it's not gonna expand it. So I can't just go over here, select here, and it won't change anything on the timeline. But you can always change it. I usually recommend you don't really try to edit this manually because that defeats the purpose of the AI. So go through all the different clips that it makes for you and see if you find something useful. You also have options here for design. So this design option lets you basically change the formatting. So the layout right now is portrait, but you can make it square here. There's other options with the layout. So I could fill in the rest of it. I could fit it right here in the center of the screen. If I want, I could do split screen. You could also change the caption style. So right now it's 3 lines, but you could do 1 line captioning. This is just fine. Caption positioning could be changed. So if you want to take it all the way to the bottom or to all the way to the top for some reason, you could go ahead and do that. I usually leave that on auto. You have caption transitions, how it basically goes from one caption to another. The karaoke, this is the color that you see over here that could be changed as well. This is the auto B-roll that I mentioned that it's beta right now. So it's gonna basically try to find B-roll, which is basically additional footage here. So I'll let this finish up here to see what it came up with.
Be the best possible solution.
So you can see this is basically one of the things it found on Pixel. And it also has an option from Shutterstock. Now my video already has B-roll, so it doesn't make sense to do that, but this is a really, really cool option here. But it's still in beta, so I haven't practiced much with it, but it's worth a try. You could also add a logo as a screen overlay. So if you want a logo, for example, on the bottom, you could do that. So all these different customizable options are available. And you also have this option over here where you could connect your account directly over here. So you could connect your TikTok, your Instagram, and your LinkedIn, and you could click right here to post directly to them. Now, I usually just like to press download and download it. And I should mention, this free account here is really for testing because you're gonna get a watermark. And as you can see, I have this watermark right here. So the watermark is included in the free option, so you will have to upgrade. You could just press add more credit, for example, here. And this is the monthly plan you could get if you sign up with their yearly, or you could just pay month to month. And anytime if you go up here and click this, you could always go to your dashboard and all your projects will be available there and you could go ahead and download it. But I recommend after you choose your clips here, just go ahead and download them. Or if you like, just go ahead and link any of these platforms and share it directly from here. So if you make any content that's more than 10 minutes, this is a great way to automatically turn that into short and possibly viral videos, completely automatic as you saw. It just took basically one click. I did have to wait, but it does send you an email so you could go about your day. You don't have to just sit there and wait for it. A really powerful tool, one of the fastest growing tools in the world of AI video creation. I hope you found this video useful and I will see you next time.